Hi, my name is Henry, and today I'm presenting our work called SET, Color Event Camera Dataset. And this is joint work with Cedric Sherlink and other authors. So first, what is a color event camera? So all the works you've seen so far were basically using monochrome cameras. But recently, there's been a novel type of color event cameras that have been introduced. The way they work is basically they have a filter array behind each pixel, which can be red, green, or blue. And therefore, the events that you get now encode color information in three different channels. For example, in this color circle here, you would get events only on the blue or the red part of the moving circle. So in this work, we introduce the first color event camera dataset, which contains about 50 minutes of footage that contains both color events as well as color Davis frames. In a wide variety of scenes and lighting, including high dynamic range conditions and very fast motions. I'm now showing a couple of examples from the data set. In each case, you can see basically the Davis frames and one visualization of color events. In our data set, we include both indoor scenes, synthetic scenes, and outdoor scenes as well. We also have people moving with labels as well, where we think color might also improve detection results. And we also have driving sequences, including sequences where you have adversarial conditions like facing the sun, for example, or tunnel driving. So as an additional contribution, we tried to unravel a bit what's actually contained in this color event data. And so what we did to visualize a bit the event stream is we adapted multiple image reconstruction methods to color event data. So as an input, we have color events. And then as an output, we adapted several methods to reconstruct images. And now I'm just going to show a couple of examples of such reconstructions. And this is a high-speed sequence in which on the top right, you can see, color events. And you can see three different reconstruction methods at the bottom, including in slow motion. This is another HDR example where you can see the Davis frame actually cannot capture the whole range of the scene while the events and thus the reconstruction scan. And this is finally a low light example where again we see the advantages of events compared to traditional sensors. The dataset is available now on our website. We're pretty excited about the applications that the community will come up with, and thank you for your attention.